The government of Yemen attaches special importance to human rights.
The Russian Federation has presented its candidacy to the elections of the Human Rights Council. Russia has spoken and continues to advocate for broad participation of civil society. Human rights must be strengthened and built up, and that will remain the cornerstone of Qatari policy.
None of the advanced democracies present in this very council would have been able to ensure better than Turkey the full respect of human rights. Upholding the principles of democracy and human rights has always been high on our agenda.
Applying human rights norms and standards to complex situations ensures that states' responses will share a steady focus on the people most affected and their needs.
The Vice President for Legal Affairs of the Islamic Republic of Iran, you have the floor, Madam.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Mr. President, Madam President of General Assembly, Madam High Commissioner, human rights could only be protected and promoted in an environment suitable to multilateralism. Unilateralism, manifested by reckless disregard for rules, norms, poses an unprecedented threat to multilateralism.
United Nations Watch.
Mr. President, human rights victims around the world look to the United Nations to uphold its founding promises. 13 years ago, in the resolution creating this council, the UN promised to address gross and systematic violations. The UN promised that council members would uphold the highest standards of promoting and protecting human rights. And the UN promised that this council would, quote, eliminate double standards and politicization. Today, victims and supporters of human rights worldwide have the right to ask this panel, is the UN keeping its promises? They have a right to ask, why was Venezuela, whose Maduro government just days ago attacked innocent civilians and burned trucks carrying life-saving humanitarian aid, elected to this council repeatedly over the past 6 years? Why is Saudi Arabia, which jails innocent blogger Raif Badawi and subjugates women under a barbaric guardianship regime, a permanent member of this council? By what logic did the UN also elect China, Somalia, Pakistan, Iraq, Qatar, Eritrea, DRC, Bangladesh, Cameroon, and Cuba as members of this Human Rights Council? Why has there never been a single resolution on violations by the government of Turkish President Erdogan, once again named as the world's worst jailer of journalists? Why does this council turn a blind eye as Zimbabwe crushes peaceful dissent, arresting human rights heroes like Pastor Evan Mawarire? Finally, hundreds of political prisoners like Murad Tabaz and Nazanin Zaghari Ratcliffe have the right to ask, why has there never been a single urgent session or commission of inquiry on the abuses of the Islamic Republic of Iran, which oppresses women under a forced hijab law, tortures political prisoners, and spreads terrorism throughout the Middle East and beyond? And they have a right to know. By what human rights criteria did this council invite the Vice President of Iran to the dais of this panel? Is it not the height of cynicism to invite an Iranian official to speak, as she did just now, of, quote, disregard for rules and norms, when her government, as we speak, shows utter disregard and disdain for the human rights and the lives of their own people?
Je vous remercie. Je rappelle qu'il est important que les orateurs s'en tiennent au débat et pose des questions sur les questions évoquées par les panélistes.